Oh wow, it is working.
It worked.
Okay, all right.
Okay, look at me. Let me turn back in. Hello, thank you.
Okay, we're going to go with it. We're going to run.
We have a clicker.
Yeah, we're fancy. Hi everyone, and welcome to episode 29 of Two Sisters and Some Yarn. I'm Denise, I'm the big sis.
I'm Amy, I'm the little sis.
And we are here to share
our hot mess.
Yeah. We got whips, finishes, lots and lots of acquisitions. We've been supporting all the makers. And so we got a lot of stuff to share. But first off, I always forget halfway through. If this is your first time, thank you for checking us out.
Yep.
We appreciate it very much. And if you feel so inclined, subscribe, hit the like button, all the good stuff that everybody always says. And if you are a returning reviewer, viewer,
and reviewer, subscriber, viewer, whatever.
Thank you very much for coming back. You know. You must like our brand of hot mess, so we're appreciative of that.
Thanks for showing up, yo. How about that?
Oh my god.
Okay. Hopefully you can hear us okay. We're like still testing out this whole iPhone, which means it'll take like 8 hours to upload, but that's okay.
Yeah, and it's like, I just see a big kind of, I guess with the blinds open, I don't feel like I can see everything. So if I'm looking really weird or whatever.
You have a little glare, but oh well.
Yeah, so. Like in my glasses. I know, it's kind of hard. Look, are they trying to shade on me?
What?
My glasses.
A little bit.
Yeah.
You want me to close
the light? No, okay. We need the light, otherwise it'll be too dark.
We don't have
one. Alrighty, right off the bat, we're a hot
greatest
mess.
Production, but hey.
And I think that was it for the greetings. You know, thank you and all that good stuff. Yep. We do appreciate it.
We're going to talk about the mail.
Yeah. Oh, and before I forget, we do not do show notes.
No.
Because we are low tech. We don't do show notes. We don't edit. We don't attach links or anything like that. But if there is anything you have a question on or you need information on, feel free to message,
or comment or whatever.
Comment below. Message us on Instagram, Two Sisters and Some Yarn. We have Two Sisters and Some Yarn at gmail.com, which she checks.
I promise.
And I don't. I say that every time because I never do.
I promise.
I never do. And so got all
it's
that.
It's just, I work full time and I don't have time for all that. And she's retired and.
I don't even have a computer at the house anymore.
I really don't either.
I have a tablet in my phone. So
I have a little Chromebook that my husband uses, but that we used to record on. But now it keeps saying storage is whatever, whatever. And I'm like, that's why we started with the phone because, in which event, and I keep having to delete them. So if YouTube ever deletes us, oh well.
Oh well, such is life. It's not like we're, Oscar worthy performances. So.
So, our Mal.
Yes.
Talk about that. Two sisters and some yarn, Mal, Cal. Whatever you want to call it.
Make along.
We said make along, but whatever you want to call it.
Knit, crochet, wince,
I did follow. Weave. I did see a lot of people post. I did see some finishes. I saw some socks and some. I can't remember if that person finished the blanket or not. Because that was cool while she was striping the.
I think they may have.
I have to go check. So if you didn't hashtag us or tag us, I don't see it unless I just happen to see it in the feed and we follow you.
Right.
So.
And the only place we're going to see it is.
Instagram.
Instagram, because that's the only place we go. For that kind of thing.
So what we will do is we will pick a winner from comments of this video.
Yes.
But please keep tagging us because I've tried to share them. So if you're public and I see it and you tag me, I shared it.
I see it. That's how I see it.
But if you're not public, I can't share it.
Right.
So I'm not going to screenshot your picture and share it because you're private for a reason. You might not want people to do that. So.
Right.
So I've seen some really cool stuff.
Yeah.
I know Tara just finished her socks last night. She sent that to me.
Did she?
I don't know if she posted it yet. Somebody else did. Brenda did a shawl. That was really pretty. I shared that.
Was that a murder knit shawl?
Yeah, that was the murder knit shawl. That was really cool how it striped up. I'll show what I'm
working
on.
That's a cool shawl.
That's a cool shawl. No, yeah.
Where's that pattern at?
She just wrote it up. I have a screenshot. It's on her Instagram, but I'll
send
share
it to me.
It's not. She'll tell you. It's not rocket science. It's just, something she does.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think what else I saw done. What did you?
Was there a hat?
I think there was a hat.
Blanket. I don't remember.
I know there was more, and I'm just missing.
Lots of socks.
Yeah.
Lots of socks.
Yeah,
because
some people did the Gingy Knits. Gingy Knits did the patterns.
Yes, because she had the patterns. So I did see that.
Because Carista did the socks.
And somebody did the mitts.
Yes. And I.
So there's been a lot.
I bought the pattern.
For a.
I had intentions to do the pattern.
I did too.
As per our hot mess, that did not work out.
Yeah. I'm so easily distracted.
I'm so easily ADD. I'm like, rip, 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 rip. But never mind. I'm going to do it this way. I'm going to change my mind. I'm just messing. So.
Yeah.
So, but
oh yeah, I'm the same way.
I am excited to maybe do those TK socks once we when you share that next.
Yes, that,
but know, anyway, that's your, a sidebar.
Yeah.
So anyway,
because you got something for me too.
I do.
You have to swap.
I know. So sidebar.
We enable each other.
Share. Keep sharing on Instagram and tag us, please. We'll keep sharing them because if you finish it a month from now, I don't care. Whatever. We want to see it. So.
Okay. If they comment below, do they have to have finished something in order to qualify?
No, they need to have done something. Remember our rules were
okay.
Preferably Carista's yarn, our yarn. If not, here's all these other things.
Well, I'm mentioning that because, you know, some random person sees giveaway and then they post. Right. I mean if you have to be a subscriber.
You have to be a subscriber.
You have to like the post.
Yeah, you have to like
That's what everybody says. Like it and subscribe.
Yeah. Well, there's certain giveaway rules. You have to be very careful how you word that. But
okay.
You definitely have to be a subscriber.
Yes, whatever the parameters are for giveaways, we wish to stay within those.
Obviously, if you're not on Instagram, but you watch us and you got the yarn, just let us know, you know. I mean, because not everybody's on Instagram.
Right.
So, I mean, if somebody's not on Instagram, but they watch us and they bought the yarn, that's not fair that they don't get a shot. So,
right.
Just in some way, tell me.
Can you attach pictures in the comments?
No, but they can shoot me an email or just say, hey.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, anybody that goes to the trouble say, yes, I made this pattern with this yarn.
Really?
Yeah, there's not that many.
Yeah, we're not.
Especially because we hadn't even told them what they're getting.
Yeah, we're not the knitting. It's in the closet there or in a tote bag.
I know.
There's a lot of stuff in there, but I don't know what it is.
So, I mean, anybody who goes to the trouble to be like, yes, I'm pretending to make this so I can get whatever, and they don't even know what they're getting.
True.
So,
is it more than one winner? Or how are you going to do it? I don't know.
What did we say before?
I don't know. To be determined.
To be determined.
That's how organized we are.
And let's say this. I'll say if you finish something, we'll give you a prize for that. And then we'll just pick a, you know, a whips one, you know.
How are we going to, okay.
Well, if they finish it, they can show
You're
me.
In charge, so right. However you wish to do it.
I mean, most people are also on Instagram or also know me or have a way to get in touch with me.
True.
So, true. If you finished it, tag me somewhere, send it to me, email me, whatever. And then from the other, we'll pull another comment of just, you know, whatever you worked on, whatever. You know, because I knew... Okay. We didn't want to make everybody have to go buy something they couldn't afford to buy right now. Times are tough.
Right,
so,
right.
You know, if you made stuff... You know, we just wanted you to create and have fun.
Mm-hmm.
With no drama. Be calm and knit.
Yes, we are hopefully drama-free on that.
I'm going to try.
Loosey-goosey with the rules.
That's the way I roll, man.
Okay, so she's in charge of picking. Comment below. If you participated and bought any of the yarn from any of the makers,
yes.
We appreciate
that.
Yes,
very much. Or designers
if you
or whatever.
Participated, hashtagged, whatever,
right.
We appreciate that because we know we're small potatoes.
That's okay.
We are definitely small potatoes, and we're okay with that.
No,
because,
we're okay with that.
Yeah, we're not trying to make a living or anything.
Your real friends, no, then you know who your real friends are. I'll just put it that way. Before I forget, speaking of our yarn, mm-hmm. Why don't you go ahead and show it since we're going to talk about it.
Okay.
So speaking of our yarn, our beautiful yarn, this is the DK set that it's so pretty, it's gonna say. Carista of Sweet Mountain Crafts
mm-hmm.
has a Patreon.
Oh, okay.
And to enable, if you didn't watch her latest podcast.
I haven't watched it yet. I saw it.
I watched it to see if I won, but I didn't win.
Oh.
Because my picture was in one of the match that picture.
Oh,
match that yarn.
Oh, okay.
That she died. One of them was my picture.
Oh, sweet.
But I didn't win.
I haven't watched it yet. I've seen the posts.
And I want the yarn. So she better figure out a way to give me that yarn. But anyway, she has a Patreon with different levels because she has a goal of getting a studio. Like a dye studio moving out of her garage.
Okay.
So there's different levels. One of the levels happens to be that you get yarn every month.
Wow. I need to go watch your podcast.
I know. You got your phone.
I will.
Get on Patreon. She only had like 10 spots for it. So.
I'm sure I've missed it.
No, I doubt it. I think there was only 3 yesterday. So anyway, she has different levels. You can buy her tea.
Because I'm Patreon for
whatever,
a couple of other
podcasts. So Sweet Mountain Crafts. And one of them is that you can, you know.
If you hear anything, that is Andrew. He licks himself and then he gags. I mean, he's a.
Let's hope he doesn't.
No.
He doesn't come up.
He licks himself. Gets
hair. Executive producer.
Yes. Oh, gosh.
That's its contribution.
If that grosses out anybody wearing earbuds, I'm so sorry. Usually he's quiet and sleeps through it. I didn't mean to interrupt you. I'm sorry.
No, but that was pretty gross.
Yeah, that was pretty. What's really fun is when he actually goes outside and eats something and come back and throws it up in the house.
I have 2 cats, so.
Good times there.
It's all the time. So anyway, Carista has some lovely, because she did talk about the match that yarn. the sunrise. Wait, Sunset Surf was my pick. Was my picture.
Ah.
And the yarn she dyed from it was not what I thought she would have done, but I really, really liked it. You would have really liked the geyser one. That one that was blue and gray.
Really?
So she does plan to dye those and have them available. Just
Sweet
not,
Mountain
yes,
Crafts.
Not right now. So anyway, if you want to go support her Patreon, that would be awesome. And while you're looking that up, some other people's that I like to...
Well, that's yours.
Oh, that's mine. That's
right. Yeah, I ordered. She started dyeing DK. First, it was sock. And her sock base is pretty
really
thick to begin
thick.
With.
Nice,
and that's DK. And I just ordered two and gave one to her.
I have one for you. So, anyway, that's one way to support her. But there's other ways if you want. But I think because I'm a Patreon for Neil for the Blocked magazine, too.
Which one has to get to the yard?
That one, 40. So you get either minis or sock sets. Every month. And I'm sure you can change it if you want.
Mm-hmm.
But I went ahead and did it because I've been very good, despite the pile of acquisitions that I will show for the months of February and March. I've been better and I've done very good since January.
Yeah. But, yeah, I need to look because I'm already in two other Patreons.
So, but I don't get any other monthly yarn. Like, I don't have any other clubs or anything like that, so I figured I would go ahead and do that and give that a try. And then if I get too much, I'll just back off and give somebody else a spot, you know? So anyway, so that was my news. Also, let's see, what other podcasts I've been watching? Faith in Knitting. She is adorable.
She is sweet.
And when you have a bad day, just turn it on and listen to her. And she is Christian and does talk scripture and stuff, but even if you don't, she can read the telephone book and just calm me down.
Yeah.
She just has such a calming. Yeah. Presence that's just like, oh, just keep talking. And let's see. I have not watched the latest Naughty Nitwits. Have you?
Yes. Okay. Yeah. I usually watch it the same day.
I try, but it's usually Sundays, and Sunday is mine.
Yeah.
To run
yeah.
around and get everything done.
Do you watch Noble Character Crafts?
I do not. I subscribed it, but I think I watched one.
She's another one of those that's just calming
yeah.
and soothing.
There's not enough
She's very organized, and she's one of those that she will use every ounce of yarn if she can.
Oh, that's
She
nice.
Makes it, blankets, this, that, and the, I mean,
that's
it's
nice.
Scrappy, so, I mean,
ooh, I like
yeah,
scrappy.
I really, and she just, it, she used to dye yarn, she doesn't anymore,
mm-hmm.
and she's a bag maker, and she just had an update yesterday. Mm-hmm. It's, everything's gone, but, and
I mean, I've subscribed to her, but I don't think I've watched too many.
Yeah, I like her a lot.
I just, if I could wear earbuds at work, I could...
I can't, so I have earbuds, and all the phone and stuff, but we had the music playing, but we couldn't wear earbuds when I worked either.
If I can't watch it at night or on the weekends, and then life's just been really busy, which is why we haven't podcasted much, because we went on an anniversary trip to Dauphin Island, and then...
Well, and then we did a cruise in, I want to say 2 weeks or more ago, and right. I got burnt, and my lips got burnt.
How do you get sunburned at this day and age? You should know.
I don't usually burn or anything. I don't usually have to deal with any of that problem.
Was it one of those days where it's sneaky
it
cool?
It was cloudy and then
but
sunny.
But then it's sunny?
Yes.
And you think, oh, it's cool outside, I don't really need, like... Because we're so used to the heat. In the middle of July, obviously, if you're going to go out in the summertime, you're going to wear sunscreen. But I've been burned before in, like, March. And you're like, it's a day like this where it's, like, in the 70s. And it's cool and it's
nice.
Like
that. And it was a little bit cloudy.
And then later you're like, oh.
Tops of my ears burned and they're still peeling. It's really weird.
On the way home from Dauphin Island.
And then my mouth. And that's why you see a little something. I got, like, it was ugly.
Well,
there was
you
just
have
no
issues
way.
That make that worse, too. But
yeah.
But on the way home from Dauphin Island, because we took the Corvette and he wanted to ride top down. I don't even, like, think. And
well, windburn is part of it, too.
Yeah, but, like, so I wore sunglasses and a hat, but I didn't even think. So I had a sunglass line right there, my ears, the back of my neck, and this whole side of my face, because of the direction of the sun, was sunburn. I was like...
Oh, yeah, if you notice, I have right here to here, I was wearing capris, and yeah. I had shoes on. It's brown there, my neck.
I wasn't even thinking.
I didn't even think about it, either. No. I don't usually... get burns or anything, so that but delayed
we
it
don't
because
usually
no,
ride.
And it still looks pretty bad right now, so I mean, I apologize for it being there.
We don't
I
usually know ride that long with the top down though.
Oh.
So usually it's just around town, but he wanted to ride the whole way, and then we ended up getting caught because unbeknownst to us,
the traffic.
Biloxi had a parade because it was Mardi Gras day.
Oh,
then we drove home, so we thought, oh, we'll get off and we'll ride through. No, that didn't work. There was a parade, so then getting back to the interstate was just a hot mess, and it's like.
Then there's been the construction on the bridge.
Yeah.
And that's usually back that we get off and we take Texas Flat or something. Usually we try to.
So.
Yeah, we run into that. So, yeah, things just happen.
Things happen. So life happened and then we've just, you weren't feeling good. And then my kid has a girlfriend. So she's been doing things with her on Sundays. So I'm okay.
Yes.
She's very sweet.
She's dealing with very, very sweet. Teenage boys.
Very sweet.
Anyway. So, okay, we are 15 minutes in, right, and we've only shown one skein of yarn.
So, finishes.
Finishes. I have two finishes and two hoes.
I have...
Look at you.
More.
Well, you start.
Do you have the mitten thingy or no? If not handy, that's fine, but...
I thought I did.
Because I have the sock one. You can use your hand. You have small hands.
I can't see it.
Because my hands are too big for it, so.
Oh, is that pair for your friend?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I wanted to show the yarn, too.
Oh, look at that bag.
This is a Amazon purchase.
Mm.
I'm in some group, like, Salesaholic or something, and it's actually a makeup bag. So it's, like, plasticky.
Yeah, I could hear that, yeah.
But I'm like, that would be a perfect project. It's, like, $2 or something.
Wow.
Yeah,
I love inexpensive versions. Yes.
So you want to put that on? Hands.
Okay.
All right. This is for my neighbor and friend. This was a last year's acquisition, so.
Oh, these are so soft.
Didn't count in things. Maria Tuscan of Tuscan Knits. I snagged these on New Year's Eve. So I snagged this mohair, which I don't work with mohair very much. Like, this is probably my first time working with mohair.
I have some of her yarn. Because there was a club, and I got mohair in the club. It was like 4 months.
So this one is called Haar, H-A-A-R.
Mm-hmm.
This one is called, it's a fingering, called Love Letter.
Yes.
This was Slip Stitch Studio, Skein Cozy, Love Letter. So my neighbor got married this year, and her new last name is Haar.
Spelled the same?
Yes.
Wow.
Which... I don't even know what it means for Maria. It must mean something. Otherwise, Maria wouldn't name the yarn that.
Right. I can't remember.
I think I Googled it and it means like sea fog or something. Which kind of makes sense because it does look like sea fog. Mm-hmm. So that's probably where she was going with it. But that's their last name. It's a weird last name. It's not like, it's kind of like my last name. It's not common.
I love how it changed the yarn.
I know.
So I held these two together.
So anyway, love letter and her last name. I had to make something. And look how much I have left to make me a hat or whatever. So I asked her what she wanted and she placed darts. So I said, well, I'm going to make you fingers. And her hands are small like yours. So they looked more stretched out on my hand when I tried them on. So look how fuzzy. Look at the halo. Hopefully that's okay for her when she's playing darts. But
that ought to be. I don't know if you can pick up
on the
halo.
I mean, she can fold that down.
Yes.
If it's too,
I'm trying to see if they can pick up on the halo.
Yeah. So she could fold the finger part down. And so I just thought that was a lovely coincidence.
It's very, very soft. But we all know mohair makes everything soft.
It does.
Soft.
And I mean, I told her, I was like, okay, well,
are they blocked?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I'm like, when you spill beer on it, you cannot just throw it in the washing machine. Come to me and I will help you. So, because they play darts at Mr. C's over there on gauze.
Okay.
So that is Amanda's fingerless gloves.
Very cool.
Hopefully they fit her and hopefully she's... And I will say, let's see if you can notice it. Look at the difference on these. The stitches.
What about it?
Look how much more defined this one is than this one. Because Liz told me... Well, I think it was Liz. Told me knit in the back...
Yeah, it's a twisted rib.
Instead of...
One by one twisted
rib.
Right,
look how much tighter and prettier it looks.
Yes, yes. Yeah, one by...
I was just doing knit one purl
A lot
one.
Of people don't like the one by one twisted rib because it's knit through the back loop.
Yeah, but I like
love
that.
I love it. I love it.
So I had never tried that before.
Being a continental knitter, it's easier for us. But English knitters, right. it's not as intuitive.
So Amanda won't notice, but I did it on one glove to see. Yeah. And I do like how it looks a lot better because I don't like how wide those stitches can get.
Yes. You they know. Do look sloppy sometimes.
So, and I mean, I've never worked with mohair, so it was obviously a little more fiddly than other things. But I did not know that trick. So
you didn't know about that?
I mean, I knew it was a stitch. I just never thought of it for the ribbing like that.
Oh, I like it on softs, too.
That was a trick.
Very cool. Well, you just keep going till you're done and finishes.
You never know what people, you know, don't know. So, I, you know, it's good to share a little.
Aww, look how cute. Baby socks.
So, this is baby socks. Oh, I got a little end weave sticking out, poking out. These are baby socks for a friend having a baby. Leftovers of my, and my Amy hair on it, sorry. Leftovers of DK socks that I made for me. I think this is of Carissa Jean. This is the one that was at the suite with this bag.
Oh, yeah. Which is those there.
Yes. So this is leftovers.
Of that. Yeah, I haven't cast mine on yet.
So one little pair of baby socks.
Cool.
Man, I got hair everywhere. I don't know if it's my hair or the dog's hair or what, but I don't know. I got hair all over the place.
Yeah, the longer one's on the wall. I can't reach it.
No, that's a matter in my bag, but.
Oh, okay.
But that's okay. This will work too. So, get in there. This one.
Oh, you want to do both of them like that? Okay.
So, anyway, this is Carissa's. I forgot what she called it. Sweet something?
I can't remember either. It was that kit with the.
It was the kit because the bag is.
What is it? Little Delights.
The bag is Delightful Works.
Delightful Works. I knew Delight
was in. It's a really cool bag.
Yes, I love the bag. Really love the bag. I bought it because of the combo of the bag.
Yeah, I mean, it looked really good together. And I don't know.
Yeah, these are smaller sock markers.
It's kind of hard to tell how they look, but yeah, my feet are gigantic. I'm much more bigger than these lockers.
And these are the DK, right?
These are the DK, which I don't know that I'll ever make fingering weight socks again.
I have a buttload of fingering sock yarn. If I don't use it in
but
a blanket,
but you can hold two fingering.
Yes, you can.
DK, right?
Yes, so, you can get that marl right. Look. Yeah.
So I'm just saying, this was way faster, even with my gigantic, enormous feet.
Very pretty.
I mean, look how long my feet. This is the shorty for me.
I've got it caked up. I just haven't. I was trying to finish a few things before I got crazy and cast it on.
It is pretty.
Cast on 10,000 things.
Not you.
Trying to do better. Oh, I forgot my little book. Oh, well. I've been writing everything down in a book.
And then this one is Molly's DK yarn, which I barely made it on this one. I think I had to fudge somewhere.
Well, you got a longer leg on this
one. I know. I have bigger feet and a longer leg, so I had to fudge somewhere. I don't remember where I fudged, but...
Even with the mini?
Yeah. I was down to, this much in the mini.
Oh, wow.
So somewhere along the way, I fudged. What's the colorway? It was one of the Encanto, whatever.
Okay.
I don't remember which one this was.
Yeah, I got some of that last. I think I showed that last time.
Yeah, I mean, we showed it before.
Did I get this one? I don't think so.
I think you did.
Did I? Okay. I think
so. You got one of the ones I got the same.
Oh, okay.
I think I fudged on the heel somewhere. I think it's because I think I ran on a mini, so one row was, and I don't remember. Okay. You can't tell.
Yeah.
But I was like,
and if you hadn't said anything, I wouldn't have.
I was like, whoa.
I love the little acid green. Can y'all see that?
That's
the
pretty.
Acid green speckles in
that.
Yeah,
that's pretty.
I love that.
I don't think I have the, I might have the bag. I might have the bag, hold up.
Oh, it's tagged?
Oh, no, I have Chris's in there. Nope.
Talk amongst yourselves.
Sorry, I don't. It's one of the Disney and Encanto ones.
I don't remember the names on all these
yards. I can't because I didn't know one was. There were words I can't say for the most part
because they were Spanish. So one was abuela. And,
I couldn't say them anyway.
Which is
I don't think it was the Bruno.
Which
one.
Is grandmother.
I think it was the other one.
Yeah, I got a couple.
There was a Bruno. There was a something else, and I think
I got two, and one of them might have been the same as yours.
I still haven't watched that movie.
I don't watch.
I mean, I don't have. A lot of movies. I do watch some kids' movies, but
I've been working my way through shows and old shows at that.
Well, I've been watching Poldark. You ever watch that?
Nope. That's,
oh man,
I've heard about it.
Elizabeth from You and I.
Uh huh.
God, she's dying in Minisad, which I can't wait till they're ready. But she's got me watching it. And
is that everything?
That's all.
Okay. All right.
So it's really good, and he's really.
I've seen it listed, but I've been working my... We're still working our way through NCIS. We're on season 16.
He's really pretty.
Well, so is Mark Harmon. I love me some Mark Harmon, so... We're working... We never watched that when it came out, and now, you know, we've been watching... And we've been, we watched, two or three episodes a night.
I know. I watched, I binge.
We have no life. We watch TV. We're retired.
Me and my true crime. I just watched Big Bad Vegan on Netflix. Finished that last night.
Okay, this was a whip that I think I showed at one point, and I have finished this... Oh, the way up. It's a crocheted shawl. It's really big. And it's a bag a day tutorial, Crystal. I think it's like Bobbles. Cool Bobbles Run Through It or something, I think is the name of it. I don't think it's a pattern on her Etsy shop. It's an actual tutorial. And I used,
Is this a Karen cake?
No. Mm-hmm. This is Hobby Lobby, the cotton cakes in the solids.
I'm stuck.
And it's got crocheted baubles. And it sat for a while because I ran out of the gray.
Oh.
Yeah, I think I ran out of the gray because in order to finish the repeats and have it not look stupid, even if I did, you know. I finally remembered to get another cake, and then after that, I was like, okay, I think it's big enough.
So
and then
that
I
sugar did, wheel cotton,
something like that, okay. Cotton solids or something.
Because sugar wheel mustard, has different colors in it.
Mustard, steel fog or something in black.
Okay, then that wasn't sugar wheel because sugar wheel is like a cake.
It is a cake,
but with different colors in it.
Oh no, this is the cake. Solids. This is the solids. Yeah. So that is done. It's a cotton shawl.
I don't know. Feels like sugar wheel.
It's nice. One of the Hobby Lobby cotton yarns. Well, I don't know. I was just scrolling in the YouTubes as we do like and saw this listed. I don't really care for baubles that much either, but
they're not super noticeable. I mean, I don't like doing them.
I've done baubles in knitting and crochet, and to be honest, it's easier in crochet.
Oh, I'm sure it is. Yeah. I don't like doing them.
That is a finish. That is a whip that has now become a finish. And then this one, oh crap, let me pull it up.
Oh, I remember that somebody else just
made this like in a day. I saw this.
Somebody else just made this. Just saw it.
Let me find
something
it.
Meal.
It's Sidewinder Beanie.
Oh.
Let me pull.
Is the one that Mark liked?
Yes. Oh, I don't know if it's on this or if it's, I don't think it is. Hang on. Let's see. Now Andrew's snoring.
I swear, every time he's in that bed, I think of that Chris Farley. Fat man in a little coat. Because he is far too big for that bed.
Yeah.
He looks like, he's just like, okay, he fits, but he's too big for it. It's a little bit sad.
Okay, this is a pattern I got on Etsy. It's called the Sidewinder Beanie. And I use the... It's a number 5 Color Made Easy Lion Brand yarn.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And because there's a chunky version and a super bulky, and I did the chunky version. It's 2 versions in 1 pattern.
That's cool.
And it's just the twisted and it's in you alternate and everything.
That part right there is really cool.
And I showed it to Mark, and Mark said, oh, that's really cool. I said, well, do you want one? And he said, yeah. And so the terracotta color in the I think it's sitting over here. Somewhere over there.
Yeah.
And I started it and I was like, you know, that far into it, and I messed up one of the twisted stitches and I can't fix it. I don't rip back. So I started over. And it's getting warm anyway. So this is the pattern. I got it on Etsy. Gosh, I don't know if it's going to be a glare or what. It's called the Sidewinder Beanie. There's the beanie.
Beanie.
Beanie, not beanie. Good Lord, Denise, language. Words. Oh, and I'm close to the microphone. Sorry if that was loud. I forget.
That's like what Tabitha's
Aspen Leaf Knits. She has lots of different patterns. In fact, I tested one of her patterns a few years ago.
That's a really cool pattern.
She's, you know, her patterns are well written. I thought, you know, it's on Etsy. And this, the particular
it's
one here.
Or bulky?
Yes. This the one in the picture here is the chunk, is the bulky, because that's Malabrigo Rasta.
Oh, okay.
And I do have a skein of that, but I
of
actually.
Course you do.
But that I have, let me get out of this. But with our climate, chunk is really all we need.
Yeah.
So that's one finish. And I'm not going to show the whip.
We
I didn't pull
need
it
one
out.
A year,
picture this in like a terracotta color,
yeah. Yeah,
probably about like right there.
Because
I had to start over.
Excuse me.
And that's did I just wiggle that?
I just
hit the tripod.
Part of the experience.
Usually when I show stuff to Mark, he's like, "Oh, that's wonderful." I'm like, "Thank you for playing." And he actually thought it was cool, and he wanted a hat. Because he tried that one on, and it fit him snug, and he's like super snug. So
I will
get that finished in him.
Except for the beast of a blanket. I laid it out.
Yeah.
He was like, he's like, yeah, that's big. I'm like, yeah, it kind of got away with me for me. But oh well, I'm committed now.
Oh, the corner to corner.
Corner to the corner. I didn't even bring it, because I'm like, there's no way to even show it on here. Like, there's no way. It's literally like queen size.
Oh, okay. So you didn't even bring it?
No.
Oh, okay.
It would have been ridiculous to try.
Yeah,
to
my corner to corner still.
So I'll take a picture.
I just started
done.
Decreasing on that one, and so I haven't. I kind of lost interest on it.
Because in retrospect, as a baby blanket, it would be fine. But if you're going to make it big, it's quite cumbersome mm-hmm. to flip mm-hmm. back and forth,
it
especially
is.
As you start decreasing. And it's, of course, any crochet blanket, any blanket's big and cumbersome. But. And I will take a picture and show it because it's the yarn that I got for that cleanse quilt that mm-hmm. I started and I was mm-hmm. mad at and I was stupid to
do it.
Yeah. But the lovely Ann Pinkova of Deplorable Knitters is rocking hers.
Oh. Okay.
No. So she said it was fiddly, but she's obviously a much more proficient knitter than I am.
Yeah, she designs
it. I know.
Anything,
she does like color work and attire
yeah.
and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So that's above my pay grade, but hers is coming out really cool. But it's the same colors. Like, that's what I bought the yarn for. So I ended up turning it into the corner granny thing for a lady at church. So I'm trying to finish it before Saturday so I can get it to her. So that's why I don't have much else finished. All those finishes were for, like, January and February.
Well, those are the two finishes I've got. The next two things are technically hose. I have finished two socks.
We like a hoe.
And this is the first one. This is Granite State Yarns. That's the first one. It's
what's
a DK
color?
Weight yarn. I get ready to show it.
Oh.
And the see the stitch marker?
Mm-hmm.
That's a chocolate bar stitch marker from 3 by the Sea Designs.
Cool.
Love that. It just, oh wait. Oops, show it where
I think
it's actually.
I showed it. I did. It just flipped over when I moved it.
It always flips. And this is the colorway. It's hashtag 30 minutes of knitting. I actually bought this on the Crazy Sock Lady Co. website. Because she dyed this yarn for Kay.
Oh, okay.
And 30 minutes of knitting is one of her hashtags, mm-hmm. you know, that she, for when she mm-hmm. posts. So
it's
I just thought the yarn was really pretty.
It is really pretty.
And it's the DK yarn. And I used the numbers from Kay's vanilla DK vanilla sock mm-hmm. pattern. But I make my heel bigger.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of, and I do the medium size, 48 stitches. I think I did 15 or 20 here. I do set, it's 17
mm-hmm.
instead of the 12. I do extra.
I had to alter mine
to make mine deeper because as the older you get, the thicker your feet get.
Right. I started to follow her pattern, but the stitch counts, all her stitch counts didn't work for me. So I think I ended up somewhere in the middle.
You adjusted the numbers,
And basically I just did a vanilla sock with fish lips because heel.
Yeah.
I mean, I just.
I love the slip stitch heel flap.
So.
And then I think I did like 30 rows for the foot
yeah.
and then did the toe in her pattern.
Right.
And so finished that. And I actually finished it yesterday, last night. And just to show that I actually did it, it's only like 2 rows, but I have cast on the second sock.
And what bag is that, Denise?
And it is living in a bag from Mountain State Stitches. And I think on another Crazy Sock Lady pin, turn it around. That's her pin for the 30-minute, hashtag 30 mm-hmm. minutes of knitting. I'm sorry. I just really like her stuff for Kay. I obsessed with the bags from Mountain State Stitches,
okay.
Jenny.
She won't come to your house, Kay. It's all right.
Oh, good Lord, no. I would never. She wouldn't watch anyway. So. But that's what that is. And the
other
whip I have,
Is that Sina's?
Yes.
Oh, she's back, you know.
I know, I saw.
So I will aggravate her and show her this.
This is Primitive Old Glory in DK. Where's my...
Dyed by a Winded.
Winded yarn and fiber. Let me pull out her little tie.
Where'd your little flag come from?
That is also from 3 by the Sea Designs.
Okay.
And here is Tina's tag.
She's not dying yet again, but she is back and has resurfaced, and we are very happy.
And this is called Primitive Old Glory, and it's got cashmere in it.
Oh, I see. It's very soft.
Because it says Secret Stash DK. She did it special.
Oh.
she pulled it out.
Really
she was extra
she
super
again.
Sweet. This is the... I like how it knit up,
mm-hmm.
and I think I did a shorter, and I did way too many rows on the heel, but
it does look
fit.
Longer, yeah.
Yeah, but... I think I did 20 instead of, which equals 40 rows.
Right, right.
Instead of the, because I lost track.
I
do 20 on fingering, and I confuse myself,
that's
and
okay.
still 30 rows for the foot, even with the deeper, mm-hmm. and I think, and this is, and I did cast on. 2 rows for the second one. But this is the yarn of, like, and I've had this yarn for, proof of life.
We've had it a long time. And somebody gave us that back,
yeah,
right?
This was a viewer gave us this. I can't remember.
I feel bad.
I'm terrible. But she doesn't sell bags or anything like that.
It's because people's names and usernames.
Yes, I get confused.
Blend together in my head. Plus, I never know if people want you to say anything.
And that was the inside.
Like, maybe not everybody wants to be.
I just thought it was really sweet. She was generous enough to make the bag and send it to us, and I claimed it. Sorry.
I have one too.
Oh, did you?
She made one for both of us.
Oh, I thought I stole it.
Nope.
But I did cast on the second one. So
I think they're different, but we both got one.
Oh, okay, cool.
Which we very much appreciate.
Yes.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, I can't remember.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So that's done.
But I never know who wants to, like.
Oh, and I have two more. Okay, that's technically the finish or whatever. And I've got two whips to show.
Okay, I've got more than that, but.
Well, you whips, go. So. You go.
Just because I drug some up from the dead.
Are any of them socks? Do I need to leave these out?
This one is a hoe and a sock.
Okay. Let me get back on here.
But my monkey feet.
Is that murder knit yarn?
Yeah.
I had that too. I haven't cast it on yet.
This is Murder She Knits by
You and I. Is she dying again?
Yes, she is. She's got the pole dart set coming up.
Oh, that's right. You did say that.
So this is as far as I got in my second sock.
And this is the first.
My socks are so much bigger than your socks.
And now that you feel you don't have, I don't see.
Right, now that
I mean, there's always a little bit,
yeah.
But not as noticeable.
And I might have showed this last time. I don't even remember. But
you may have, but it's always good to see how much
looking. I got that far before.
Oh, and you're doing toe up.
Yeah, I always do toe up.
And I always do cuff down.
I hate cuff down.
And I hate toe up. And that's what I learned was toe up and everything. And
I have done one of those DKs I did cuff down, but I don't like having to figure out my feet. It's just, because of fish lips kiss, it's just easier because I know exactly what spot.
And
to
I
stop
do the
at.
Heel flap and I know how many rows.
Yeah. And now if I'm doing for somebody else, it doesn't matter. If I'm doing an afterthought heel, I don't care. But if I'm going to do fish lips kiss heel, I want to do toe up.
Oh, okay.
Because I got to stop at a certain point on my foot because it's for me.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah.
So. Alrighty. This is, who is this bag by? I don't remember. Oh, Steel City Stitcher. I guess she still makes bags. I don't know.
No clue.
I think she might have been somebody that outed me, ousted me. So, but anyway, this is my attempt for my two sisters and some yarn mal. So that's the fingering, two sisters and some yarn. So
yeah, I made a pair of socks
after multiple starting and stoppings because I'm insane. I decided to make a bunch
Way
of grannies.
Too many little pieces for me.
Well, here's what happened. What I want to do is. I never have learned, what you call it, join as you go.
Right.
And I've watched videos, and it's really not hard.
No.
So I don't know why I've never really done it. So basically, my intention is to do a whole bunch of these, and I used up all the purple and the blues in here somewhere.
Is that your Libby bag?
Yeah, it's my Libby bag. And the blues. So.
Which is the two minis.
Yeah, so I have this much left.
You might between the two of them get a square.
Yeah, I might. Look, they're doing a little paw.
Oh.
It fell off my bag. It was used to hang on the bag, but it fell off. It's a little paw because I had a pug bugle once upon a time. So anyway,
her name was Libby.
Her name was Libby. So I got this Stroll fingering weight, which I've started some squares with this. So I'm trying to decide: am I gonna just like stitch them all together? But I also thought about maybe making like. Bigger squares and the little squares.
Yeah.
I'm still deciding how I want to put it together.
Yeah.
But either way, I might try just join as you go. Because if that's the case, then, you know, this is the middle and you have a gray around it, you know.
And then when you do the gray around it, that's when you'll do the join as you go.
Right. Because then you'll be joining the other one. Gotcha. So then you don't have to sew them all together.
Right.
And I watched the videos and I'm like, well, it's really not that hard. I don't know why I never.
Did that years ago.
Because I'm lazy and ADD.
Well, we get in our habits.
So we'll see what I do with those and how long those take. It might be a while.
What else you got?
I got my friend's bag.
Is that Fate's?
From Fate Threads.
That's a big one. Oh, my nose itches, sorry.
I've got just another cozy up knit. It's the whole fam.
It's the whole fam.
This was, did you get this? This was the purple rain. It was like five colors of purple. Did you the one that gave me this?
I think so. Did I get it from the shop? Okay.
It was like smooshy.
Yeah.
Whatever it was.
God, that was a long time ago.
I know. I never used it. So I had them all skeined up, and I made one, and then I don't know what happened. There might have been wine involved, and I did not decrease right, so I ended up just making it a flat one. So I'm going to do the whole thing where you make it a, like, hat, like, kitty cat hat.
Ooh.
Because I didn't do the decrease right, and I lost stitches, and there was wine involved, so I'm either going to sew on a little ears and make it a little cute kid hat, or I'm just going to, whatever, but that one I'll do right.
That marled up, that's really cool about the, you know, combining yarns, whether it's this pattern or anything else.
Where did my thing go?
The cool marled effect.
I know. And then I have
Stephen West has a lot of patterns with the marled.
Yeah. Use that for a pom-pom.
Stephen Weiss uses the marling a lot.
Yeah, I really like marling.
I think some of Andrea Mowry's sweaters use
really like
her, like the fade with the marling a
little
bit.
Yeah, it just looks cool. I mean, it's a great way to use up fingering. I mean, the set, how long ago did you buy it for me?
Years.
So.
Years ago.
Because I love purple and I like prints, so with Purple Rain, so. All right, last one. So this is another plan, change of plan. This is in my bag from Tiffany at Southern Sparrow.
Handmade
on Etsy. She made our logo.
I have one of that, but it's one of her seconds.
Oh.
It just has a little bit of puckering, but
I have the cat one too, and I haven't showed that one lately. With the cat with the little plastic glasses. That's really cool. I haven't showed it lately.
Yeah, I like that one.
So what this was gonna be was I bought a bunch of Hobby Lobby yarn, this variegated stuff for my Addy machine, and it does not like my Addy machine does not like it.
Ooh.
It seems like when it's over dyed, it just gets stuck, and it's a pain in the butt. And if it does not smoothly go, I'm out. Peace out.
You can get the bumblebee out the window.
Bumblebee.
One of those big carpenters.
So, in fact, Denise. Katrina is borrowing my Addy right now so she could just play with it.
Okay.
So anyway, so I was going to take all these little overdyed and make corner to corner squares, and I was going to sew them all together.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to sew them all together because they don't, somehow, even though I did the same amount of rows, didn't end up the same size.
That happens to me all the time.
So I thought,
and it's something I'm fixing to show up.
At first I was like, okay, well, they can either go in my stash for Abigail's Hope for the preemies and stuff, or they could also go in a stash for the animal shelter, because that'd be like the perfect little size
for a little cat,
for a little blanket in their little cages that they have to stay in, you know. And then they could just, you know,
and it's acrylic yarn.
It's acrylic, so I mean, they could fold it up for the little cats, or they could just whatever. So that's what I'm gonna do. I have
cats or dogs.
This one.
Alrighty.
This is all Hobby Lobby. I love this yarn.
Okay.
And obviously, I haven't woven in the ends.
Okie dokie.
This one.
Very cool. I like that combo.
So I was going to, you know, sew them all together in one big giant patchwork kind of thing.
Yes.
But then somehow this one was way bigger. Even though it's the same number of stitches.
Tension. And sometimes the yarn in the same line, depending on how it's dyed, some of it's softer than others, some of it's thicker than others.
So this one
even though it's mass produced.
This one is in progress.
Oh, that's a good combo.
I know, I like this color. So I'm going to pair it with this green.
Oh, very cool. What's the color?
This one is Fuzzy Slippers.
Ah, cool.
So.
Did you do it on the 30% off?
Sure. I've had them for a while. So these were going to be one big giant blanket.
But
so
now you can make them donate. They can be
different.
For donations. Yeah.
So
I'm sure they'll appreciate that.
Well, I know they always collect towels. It's like if you have old beach towels,
old
towels, they collect them to put in the cages.
Mm-hmm.
So
very cool.
So I was like, you know what? What the heck? She Who Shall Not Be Mentioned used to make blankets for the one here.
Okay.
So anyway,
is that it?
Is all my whips.
That's all your whips. Okay.
Now I gotta put them
I got three to show. The two socks that are in progress. Ooh, I knocked something off there. What is that?
Probably yarn.
Oh, that was in there. Sorry. Distracted. I'm easily distracted. All right. Here's another Mountain State Stitches bag. I got that in one of her updates with the orange slices with roses. I just like the style of bag and how thick they are.
I know, they are very nice.
I don't know, it just
makes
me happy.
That's why I like
happy.
This one, it's like canvas, you know?
Okay. I showed this before, and I don't know how much I've done since I showed it originally, but I love the colors.
Well, I ripped mine out, so you're further than me.
On New Year's Day,
Sorry, Betty. We
cast on.
Sorry, Betty, wait.
Hey, dude, where'd it go?
I don't know.
It's unraveling. Hang on.
Like a
Betty White passed away, and we cast on our Golden Girls.
In case you lived under a rock, you didn't know that.
And this is the, that's the yarn.
I still can't figure out where it is on the phone. Like, I keep trying to go to the wrong side.
And that's not L fibers. And that's the Golden Girls colorway.
Which is so the Golden Girls.
Like, it is. It's just perfect. And I cast on, and I am doing the... all right, you have long arms. All right, monkey arms.
Right up, you want to fold that.
Yes. And I am doing...
that cheesecake or cake thing. That's perfect.
Because I like her patterns. Oh, yeah, that's 3x3 design. Mm-hmm. I think it's like a strawberry cake or something.
Which matches perfect.
Yes, that's why I did it. And I'm just doing the Rhinebeck Roomies by Kay.
I guess I'll show this out without...
Crazy Cock Lady. I just always enjoyed her podcast,
yeah,
and I like her.
And I like.
I am not a weird person, okay?
Well,
not
in other ways,
and not that way. Not in that way.
I liked mine.
She made
it
sound like I was a stalker. I'm not a stalker.
It's called a joke. Ooh, that's a wasp, not a carpenter bee.
Well, that's not what I saw.
I know. I'm just letting you know you have wasps over there.
Oh yeah. Spiders too.
It's called Living in the Country. I started my and I got pretty. I think I literally turned a heel. I think.
Did you?
And then I still ripped it out because it just, I was doing the slip one, knit one to make the, you know, the, when you get to a new color, slip one, knit one.
Yeah, yeah.
And it just wasn't showing as much as I would have liked because the color.
I do like the texture on this and you can still see the stripes.
And I think it was too small when I tried it on. So I was like, I just had a,
well, I usually,
had a hissy fit and frog knit.
Okay. I get that.
But it's going to be a Musselburgh hat now.
Oh, okay.
Y'all can hold me to that. So.
Well, I usually just do a shorty. And this pattern has you go for, I think it ends up being like 70 rows almost. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go to 60 rows. But because of this, I don't know if you notice it, you can tell it's a little bit bigger looking.
Yeah.
And I tried it on my ankle and my, you know, my fat legs and everything now. And so I'm going to go ahead and do this one longer because I like the pattern, like the stitch pattern and the texture. So eventually I'll get that finished.
I kind of went.
But
that's
the one I've been working on.
All the DK socks, and then that blanket is like my nemesis until I can finish it. So, like, I must finish this blanket. It's ridiculous.
And then I have two more whips.
That's so pretty.
Okay. Recently, tried to do it when it's a 30% off. I went and got a few skeins of the Hobby Lobby Yarn ID. And
they have pretty pastel colors.
Yeah.
Sorry.
I am so sorry if that was loud in somebody's earbuds. Andrew even jumped up. So sorry. That was my fault. It fell out. I think it fell out of the yarn, maybe. I stick it in the yarn.
Please don't send us the bill for your hearing.
Yes, and so we apologize for that. Put that down at the bottom.
I'll try to put a warning.
All right.
That is
so
cool.
I did four squares, which didn't come out the same.
Well, yeah, but you could fudge these more than
I did, and I did. So I did the four in the
soft.
Middle. It's that yarn ID, and it's a little bit thicker, it seems like, than the usual Hobby Lobby yarn. I'm not sure what's showing, there's the four, and I did a border out around each of them in this lighter color, which is called Oats.
That's really pretty.
And the blue is called Blue Stone. The peach is called, which is that one up there, Soft Shell. And the pink, which is almost gone, is, I think, called Rosewater.
So how far are you going to go?
Well, I've got two more skeins, I think, of some of the yarns.
Yeah.
And the pink is Rosewater. And then this mustard color that I'm working with now, wherever it's at, right here.
Oh,
that might have been where the hook was. That is called Dijon. So right now I got the four squares together, and then I'm just making, just to kind of finish up. I did the pink first. Now I'm doing the mustard.
Mm-hmm.
Then I think I'm going to do blue, and then
that's really pretty for spring.
Just finish it up, and then just kind of like, because I haven't used this color yet. This one is called Fawn. That would have been bad. That would have been bad.
I mean, this would be great.
And then I just finish it off with the border.
Over the back of the sofa for spring.
And if
beautiful.
You look at the curtains that are behind my sofa, those are the I noticed. I said, those are the colors in my curtains.
Oh.
Which is, I guess that's why I like
but
it.
That's what all the colors they have is very pastel-y.
Yes.
I
and then
that.
They have,
very
there's other colors. I didn't get all the colors.
No, there are, but they're not like as
I want it to be, I want it to kind of be, you know, like a little bit bigger than a lap blanket.
Like snuggle sofa size.
Yes, and I'm gonna put it on the back of the sofa because it actually does these colors match my curtains.
Well, I know you like to coordinate things, so
yes, I do.
It's a good spring one.
And then my last whip, because I've been working on this.
I like that. cats.
This is my Scrappy.
Is it got a thing? Big. It's okay.
If yes. Okay. Yes. It's got one of the. I always put the stitch marker. Because what I do is wherever it's at.
Up here.
Right there. I always put a stitch marker in to keep it from
wrapping. Oh, look at you with your little Scrappy Sunday.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, see where that is? That's where, when I showed it last time, that's where I was.
I don't remember you showing this.
It's been a while. It's been quite a while. Oh. So, this much is what I've done since I originally showed it.
All right, I'm going up. And okay, I was, you ready?
Yeah.
That is really cool.
This is one big Scrappy Granny. And what I did, I think I put this together.
I love this.
In 2020, when we were on lockdown, because I put that big monster one together.
Yeah, you did.
And this is the last color in the Magic Knot Cake. So all that is one Magic Knot Cake.
Oh, okay.
So once I finish that, I have this yarn. I have just different half cakes or whatever. Mm-hmm. This is the next color, and I believe this is a Lolo Did It. And I want to say it's something like Living on a Prayer or something like that. Because she briefly had, she had some clubs. And I think and I got in on the tail end of the clubs at one point. And I think this is Living on a Prayer in her Lolo yarn. And this is just one big giant granny. And just, you know, and I like the way the colors ended up falling out.
Right, right. Yeah, they all kind of glow together. And that's what I did that big square that I use my church blanket in.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, it's very, still, I still use it every week. Yeah. It's still very squishy and warm. And
well, I like just the way it feels and the stitches and everything. And it's sock yarn, so it's going to take me forever.
That's what sock yarn. And you take forever. You think, oh my God, it's not going to go together with those colors. And then when they're all blended together, it works. So
that's, I'm slowly working on that. I kind of got sidetracked with that other blanket. So when I finish, you know, I think, have I started? How much of it did I? Because I do it and I turn and I turn.
I started turning too.
I don't even know if I have. Yeah, I don't even know if I've gotten all the way around. And sometimes it goes, the bigger it gets, the less.
Yeah, well, because then you start getting just like strips of it.
Yeah.
You know, you might only have a little mini and it only goes maybe half a row because mine is pretty big. Well, right now,
I'm not taking the time to make another magic because I just do the magic knot.
Right.
And to add this. And then I think behind there, there's like different partial cakes and stuff, and I'll see what looks like it might, you know. And I'm just gonna add because the bigger I get, the skinnier the stripe's gonna be, so it's not gonna be a big deal.
But when you start overthinking it, then you like thinking too much about the colors. It's almost better when you just.
Yeah, because that's what I'm gonna do. I know I have that one there, and there is a couple others there that are just partial cakes, and then, because let's face it, I don't have a shortage of yarn.
No. That's the main thing to tell you. The way prices are now,
I am thankful.
Stash down.
I am thankful I have the stash that I do.
I am thankful too because.
Being retired, my personal budget for yarn is less than it used to be, but I'm still able to purchase stuff as you're getting ready to see.
Right. And I've purchased.
Because I think next up is acquisitions, and I've been boosting the local economy of indie dyers and such.
I have two, but I literally am to the point where nothing else will really fit in that almoha.
Oh, I'm kind of that way,
too. But you have a room. I just have an almoha.
Oh, and y'all should see this room. I reorganized the corner over there for my stitching stuff, and I am just so thrilled with this room.
Did you post it on our page or just the personal page?
I think I shared some of it on our page. Okay. I can't remember what.
But anyway, it looks very nice. But
I did a video. I don't know if I shared it on our page or not.
I have that front room that's becoming a yarn room, much to Paula's dismay.
Well, you've got it set up really pretty,
I
too.
I do. I have the armoire and I have the shelves for the acrylic yarn because
I think you've got a chair in there.
Goes after the hand-dyed yarn, so.
Well, don't you have that, like, shrink-wrapped?
It's all shrink. I suck the air out of the zip.
Not shrink-wrapped, but.
But the shelves.
Vacuum sealed.
Yeah, well, by me going like this. And squeeze the air.
Oh, I thought you literally.
No, I just stick it in there.
I thought you literally had one of those things. You know how you buy the. Remember that was the thing?
No, but I bought one from Amazon. It sucked.
Oh.
But it was for food, but it sucked.
Oh, we have one for food.
So anyway,
we have Mark's all into the cooking and everything. Right. Oh, I have been eating so good, y'all. He is into the cooking and everything, and he is amazing with it.
Fiber.
So yeah,
I just squeeze the.
We're eating good. We eat better at home than going out.
Oh yeah. So you know me and my veggies. So
yes. I don't know where it's coming from.
Okay. I think it's gone. All right. Who's first? I got a lot.
I got a lot too.
Okay. All right, technically, this is not an acquisition, it's a gift.
Okay.
Because our lovely deprogrammed knitters, I'm just going to say that.
Because now it's deprogrammed.
It's deprogrammed with Carrie Smith. If you don't watch that podcast, please go do. She's amazing. Yes. I may or may not be on there in the next few weeks. We'll see. Yolanda. We call her Yo-Yo half the time, so I never say her real name. She's doing like a stash down 2022. You're supposed to use more than you bring in.
Right.
So in January, I kicked butt. And basically we have a little chat and she just pulls,
random. Did you win something?
I won this.
So you're doing stash down.
You do stash down.
And you win more stash.
She's like, yeah, I guess I wrote. I'm like,
didn't think that went through.
I didn't buy it, so it doesn't count.
No, you're right. So what you got? So I won
for January. Not that I did the most, but she just pulls
Which
one of us uses the hashtag. So, but I did kill it in January. February, not so much. February, oh, it was terrible. I don't know what happened in February.
What is that? I love looking at stuff. Oh, it's got a bag.
Oh, yeah. So this is a Brooklyn Boy Knits Knitology.
Oh, yeah, because he does a lot of the blue for the hats and the hate, so.
Yeah, let's see. You want to hold?
Okay.
And this, I've never had one of these. Wisdom Yarns Wacky Sack.
Ooh, this one's 100% worsted, superwash merino.
Look, it probably came out like a knit crate, because I remember I used to get the knit crates like that.
Gotcha.
So I've never seen these. I never even heard of
that
this one.
That is cool. What is
this? You ever heard of that?
Wisdom Yarns. I've heard of them, but not the wacky sacky.
I've never heard of it.
Super fine, 462, 50, 25, 20. Oh, it's got super wash, wool, bamboo, and nylon.
I had never heard of that.
That's your colors right there.
I know, she got my colors. They're all purple. All
right.
And then this, she told me what this means. It's pirate something. It really does mean pirate something. And
that's rustic.
I'm not even going to try. To say that word. She can tell me what it means. Again, I forgot. I'm really not going to try to say those words. But it's...
German.
Pirate in... WHOLLE.com if you are interested. German?
I think.
It says DE at the end. What's that?
Oh, that might be Denmark, huh? Dutch? It's got the two thingies on it. And it is... 100, it's 75-25, and it must not be super wash. It feels pretty rusty.
Yeah, it feels rougher, but, and look at this. I solemnly swear I'm up to no good. With a little.
Is that the Marauder's map?
Yeah.
Which is on the inside.
Yeah.
Who makes that?
I don't know. She doesn't have a tag on it.
Very, very cool. Perfect for socks.
I know. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, it's Tiffany. I'm sorry.
I wondered if it was Tiffany.
It's Tiffany. Sorry.
Southern Sparrow,
sorry. Got that. I got this cool little pouch with little, she works at a place that makes like awards and trophies and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, you gave me a laminated one for the Kitchener stitch.
Yeah.
Still use that sometimes.
Yeah, she made,
it's been a while. I usually pull it out.
Tabitha for our swap. We made Tabitha award for true crime.
Aw.
So I don't know what all this little stuff is, but I'm not going to try to open that. It's got stitch
This looks
that's
like
got stitch markers in it. So this is a little.
And this is a Lolo
lotion-y thingy.
Lolo body care. Because there's like Lolo bars and stuff like that. It's like, like knitting with curlies, lotion bars.
I'm not
going
to try to
markers.
Open that and drop it everywhere.
Yeah.
Kill everybody. I opened it once. Some stitch markers. Pretty card.
Yes, the round ones. And then the heart. That could be 3 by the sea. I don't know. But there's lots of stitch marker makers. So.
This was cool. Pom pom button install. A little button that tells you how to hook.
Oh, that is really cool. Because
I added pom poms,
Yeah.
So. This, I've never had one of these. I really wanted one. Can you see it? The row counter chain.
That's cool.
You know how you do the.
Yeah.
You move it and
Helps you keep track of the rooms.
Right. I wanted one, but I never had one before.
Very cool.
And then she made me those.
Made of the, is it extra long for you?
Probably. It's 9 3/4, so that's long.
Okay. I have whatever the white standard one.
I do too, but I think this might be
I think I gave that to you.
You did. And you gave me a baby one too, which.
Yeah, and then I went out and bought some more for myself. Yeah.
So that's my gift acquisition.
That is pretty awesome.
I know.
Very, very cool.
Yeah, I'm not sure who those little. Did you show them?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, it's got the hard and then the round ones with the little bead. It kind of reminds me of, but 3xC does it. And then there's a door knit. Let me show that.
So I have to find room for my armoire.
Oops.
That's okay.
What else you got?
All right. Okay.
Well, you do, and then I'll
You gave me this.
Yes, when I ordered the Sweet Mountain.
Because we ordered.
Oh, yeah, from Sweet Mountain. Oh, I love that. That pin.
That's her card.
Okay. Sweet Mountain Crafts.
Ooh, chocolate.
Krista, she's the one that's, hang on. It's not focusing. Let's see. Move your head out of this picture.
I think you got it.
Okay.
All right. So since you got two of the two sisters DK, gave me one.
Yes.
So you wanted the rose opal and DK.
Yeah.
So now we both have rose opal knits.
And then I also bought it in fingering. So now I have it in fingering and sock.
Yeah.
Rose opal. But so I'm just showing that.
Yeah. Because they have a podcast.
Thank you.
Rose opal.
Well, basically we just swapped.
Yeah, we just swapped. Well, because I meant to get it and then I didn't. And you said, yes. Oh, well, I did. I'm like, and you were like, oh, well, just get the rose opal for me.
Because they have a cute podcast.
Yeah,
and
they do.
These colors are really great. So now I have the fingering and sock.
She had another little, I don't know if she had a sale or I just was on a tangent, but.
She might have had a sale because I bought something else
this
over here,
This is a bulky,
too.
Her boulder.
Oh, I've never tried that.
Boulder.
Bulky.
That's a hard combo to say. So, crochet nerd. Like purple is my color, you know.
I like that pin.
So, and then this one is Alpine DK Peony.
Very pretty.
Which is such a pretty pink. So.
Very cool.
I don't know what they'll be, but.
Pretty colors.
I like them some, but I think I probably bought them in January. I mean, they've been sitting here a little while. So.
Right. Yeah, we crinkle. Sorry. Wow. Okay.
Don't be sitting in judgment.
Well, I got a fair amount to say,
too.
I know.
All right. This is Tara's fault. Because she told me about him. Arcane Fiberworks.
Okay.
He's in Canada, so it took a while. Probably,
oh, you posted about this,
I ordered it in January. No, I just got them a little while ago, but...
Well, it depends on when they die and how long shipping takes.
It took a while to ship, but it's Canada, and there was some truckers in the way.
Mystic River.
Yeah.
Which I was
going to
say Dogwood.
I knew how long it would take, so that's okay.
Yeah. When you order from Canada, you know.
Right. So it is squishy. And this is Misty Morning. This one's fingering. That one is DK. So this is Misty Morning. I mean, oh, so pretty. So, he's in Canada.
Very cool.
So, I got that. Yeah, I mean, look, he shipped it on, I don't even know what day, but it takes a while for him to come. And it was at the time that, you know, the convoy
when shipping.
Was
happening. Oh,
but,
okay.
Know, which is fine. Right. I know that's okay. So, this.
Is that purple onesie?
No, stitching. Oh, okay, yeah, Stitching Plaza did a de-stash.
Oh.
See, I'm just helping other people stash them. So, that counts in the universe, right?
Sure. Okay.
So, this was Pretty Twisted Yarns.
Mm.
And Freckled Whimsy. She was just de-stashing. So, this is a one of a kind. This one is on a fingering.
She's a hand dyed and she takes
forever. I know. But it was de-stashed. So
and I have some, and it literally took 3 months to get it.
So this is Atlas in Wonderland.
Yeah.
Atlas
in Wonderland. The yarn's pretty. Just, it's, be prepared.
Well,
it's a very
right.
long
so
wait.
I'll, you know, but somebody.
What is that one? Oh, that's Freckled Whimsy.
This is Freckled Whimsy.
Yeah.
So, but they were both de-stashed. Mm-hmm. So, mm-hmm. You know, hey, for that price.
Oh, good Lord. Excellent price.
And
what is that? Is
the
that a mall?
Beatles mini skeins.
Oh, you know,
I'm a sucker for the Beatles and mini skeins. So
very cool.
You know, I don't want to try to take them all out, but
no, I wouldn't do that.
So it's love me do, please please me, from me to you. She loves you. I want to hold your hand and all my loving.
Yeah, I love the Beatles for that, but I didn't bite on that. I've been on so many other things with her.
Minis
so.
Have been my jam lately. I don't know why. Now this.
What is that?
This complete Instagram.
Oh, I saw you post soap. That too.
The soap. Which I have a favorite soap maker in town who I love very much, and I buy her soap a lot. But
yeah, your post. I saw your post where you felt like you were cheating on.
It's already. It's Royalty Soaps, and her pictures are just like this is not remotely it, not giving a justice at all. You gotta go check out their page, Royalty Soaps. So this one, hopefully you can tell, looks like a succulent. See it?
Oh yeah.
So see, it looks like a succulent.
Did that end piece on that one look like anything?
Just the purple. Like you can cut. It's hard to tell with the plastic, but
oh, okay.
It's so pretty, and it's like got gold up here. You know?
Uh-huh. And, oh, amethyst, like the stone or something like that.
Yeah, yeah. Like it's supposed to look like, you know,
the gemstone.
Yeah.
Cool.
When you look at it that way, it's easier to tell, but not with the glare of the thing. But I just thought that was cool. Check out royaltysoaps.com because I mean, really nicely packaged. And let's see, here's their info. Hopefully you can see. So, and it came pretty quick, but she does like you gotta be ready.
Oh, like she sells out quick.
Right. So yeah. she'll post what she's got, she'll sell it, you know, and you be ready. Yeah. And then get in there and then you'll get
yeah. So yeah, there's a lot of makers where I forget about her.
Right, I set an alarm.
And even then sometimes
because I saw the succulent, I was like, I want the succulent. So
depends on what it is, okay. Whether or not I do.
I'm done.
Is that it?
That's it.
Okay. Well, talking about Sweet Mountain Crafts, this was a caramel apple sock set.
I thought
set.
About that one, but
it's sort of similar to the other one, but lighter. And but it's the fingering, it's the sock set.
Right.
So at the same time, I ordered the DK and the other fingering because I think I ordered the two DK on the two sisters,
mm-hmm.
And then right. The sock set
see,
for
I'm
the
very
rose opal.
Picky about my yellows, so.
Well, this is kind of like a gold,
right? I like the
so
gold.
So I know it's similar to the other, but that's I may have done. I have fingering a DK on
right.
That, so
that's why I wanted the one she took did for my picture because it actually was the like yellows and browns and stuff, and I didn't think I would like it, but I'm like, oh, it is really pretty. I really like it.
Yeah, you have to.
I'm picky about my yellows.
Okay, and let's see. I've done a fair amount of acquisition. Okay, I may have
shown... Hey, I have a good March. I didn't buy anything yet.
Except
for subscribing to...
I have bought so much stuff.
Patreon. I have not bought anything in March, and it is the 20th day of March.
Yeah, I bought a bunch of stuff. Okay, I mean,
I'm not counting yarn that I needed to finish the blanket. That's not for me. That's for a gift.
Okay.
Oh, and I did have a finish. I didn't say the Outlander shawl.
Oh, I did see that.
I posted
that.
But
you gave that
but
as a
But I didn't
gift.
Buy for the yarn. I didn't buy the yarn. Amanda bought the yarn. She gave me the leftover yarn. We ordered it from whatever the pattern called for.
Oh, well, I had a finish. Remember that keyhole scarf that
yeah,
I crocheted
that
I gave to my sister-in-law?
Yeah.
So that was a finish,
so I did have
too.
No finish, so.
But I gave it to my sister-in-law.
Yeah. So I gave it to Amanda.
I may have posted
you
that
did.
On our Instagram.
Because everybody liked it.
Yeah. And it was just a pattern that was mm-hmm. I got.
Somebody had, it went kind of viral, the pattern, because I had several people tag me in that and say, hey, and I'm like, I'm not going to know. Nah, you can't afford it.
Do what?
Like they wanted me to make it.
Oh, the and Outlander?
No, the other one you did.
The keyhole
one, yeah. Just because I don't have enough time in the day. I can't make...
Yeah, I made that for my sister-in-law. So we were somewhere.
Yes,
she showed
thing.
Me a picture, and then I actually...
Right.
The picture she showed me was actually from the pattern.
Right.
And I got it and said, okay, is this what you want? Okay, and do you want it? And...
Right.
If she wears it, she wears it. If she doesn't, she
right.
doesn't. You know, I mean, I made it in an evening or two. So
yeah, it didn't take me long to make the Outlander shawl, even though it was knit, because it was so big, because it was bulky weight.
Yeah.
But, you know.
Yeah.
So, I think
kinda
I
like that, crochet shawl that was worsted. Okay, yes. I am in the Cozy Knitter Monthly Sock Set Club. I got her...
It's a mouthful.
Her 24 stripe advent, and I really like how she dies.
That's
so
pretty.
And she's in Canada. So in the first of the month, you know, they take out the money and it ships around the 20th of the month. And that was January.
I really like these colors. See, this yellow I really like. I'm very picky about my
yellows.
Well,
do you want it? You can have it.
You don't have to give it to me.
You like it?
I do like it.
Take it. I'm gonna have 12 of these. one a month, so I mean,
but I like the yellows and that caramel one. It's pretty, but it's not something I would grab because it's more of a, see how the yellow's more
gold
brownish, brown. And I like yellow.
Well, you can have that if you want it.
But I love yellow and gray.
Well, there you go.
Thank you.
You can have it.
Yay.
And this is February's, which is called Fancy Pants.
No, that's pretty. That's you.
And I think today or sometime this week, the March one is going
to
ship.
Oh, okay. So it just automatically, you don't have to go in and sign.
It's an odd, no, it's, I signed up for the club, yeah, okay. I think maybe, and, each month, because you'll send an email, it's fixing to renew.
Right, right.
You're going to be charged this, right. And then when it's charged, it charges, right. Kind of thing.
So if you don't want it, you want to quit, you have a chance
she
to
gives
stop.
You a warning yeah. email yeah. saying you're getting ready to be charged, because it's the first of every month, and know it's going to get charged. And so this one, it kind of has like a denim look
yeah,
to it.
That's
it's
very,
called Fancy Pants, and she's cool. in Canada. And considering that she's in Canada, I want to say it's up in Canada above New York, up in that area mm-hmm. on the East Coast. It ships really quick.
That's
considering.
Where my friends are from. Those ladies used to come down. They haven't been able to come down.
Oh, yeah.
That's where they come in.
So this actually ships pretty quick. So that was February's. And I got in Night Owl Fibers, one of her clubs
so you too.
Is inspired by the Big Bang Theory. If you're looking on her website, mm-hmm. it's called the TBBT.
Mm-hmm. What's that one called?
Roommate Agreement. I think this is February's.
That's cool.
I think that was February's. Because January, which I've already showed.
Yeah, that was the...
Roommate Agreement. I'm sorry, Bazinga.
Bazinga. That's my favorite episode.
And...
the ball pit episode.
Oh, gosh, yes.
That's my favorite.
And that one, and then I have the soft kitty socks that I'm making.
Yeah, yeah. That...
And then, Adore Knit.
I can see it, yeah.
Okay. She does stitch markers mm-hmm. and such.
She's the one where I got the Friends and the Harry Potter.
Yeah, and I've already purchased stuff. Some, I think I bought the soft kitty charm to go with the soft kitty socks. And this one is, that's my spot.
Hopefully you can see that. I can't tell if it's focusing.
I can't tell either.
I don't even know where the camera there is. There we go. That's my spot. Block my head. It works.
Okay. And this one's Bazinga.
Oh,
so when I do that Bazinga. One, I'm going to put that on. I'm hoping Rachel does That's My Spot for one of them.
I'm sure she will.
And the March colorway is...
Has she done Knock Knock Penny yet?
That is March.
Oh, okay.
And April... Or the one that... the one that's going to ship this week for Penny is... Knock Knock Penny.
Mm-hmm.
From Rachel is Knock Knock Penny. And then the next one that I just bought that's going to ship April 20th is Comic Book Store. But Adore Knit's, she's really...
Does she already have a Rock, Paper, Scissors, Spock? Rock, Paper, Scissors,
No,
Lizard,
but
Spock.
I got that from Turtle Pearl.
Oh, okay. So she'll probably do that.
And it may or may not be a future one. Because she's not going to... I mean, you don't know until each month which
right,
one she's
Right, I know.
Done.
I'm just curious
she's
what
doing.
Phrases she uses from it,
And speaking of Turtle Pearl, so that was my... Night Owl Fibers, Big Bang Theory inspired TBBT is her in for that. And then Turtle Pearl.
Let me hold the jar.
Sure. We don't need a...
Just in case.
I bought... This is the second one.
No judgment. So is that...
Mini skate. Yes. This is her turtle toes or whatever she calls them.
She calls them turtle...
Striped turtle toes. It's actually just kind of like end bits of her bigger sets.
She doesn't say turtle toes on here. She says mini skein small party pack.
Oh, okay. Well, on the tags here, it just says striped
so maybe
toe.
You could buy these individually in their turtle toes.
Maybe. Well, I mean, these are like, I guess, like the leftovers from...
Yeah.
Because...
I mean, it's a mini skein, right? Basically.
Yeah,
it's
I think
10.
So. It tells you. See, this is like... this is Rock, Paper, Scissors, Lizard, Spock
mm-hmm.
that she does.
Right.
And then... there's a Sugar Plum Waltz, Socks from Away, Tangle.
It's 9 grams.
They're different.
10 grams. They're little ones.
This one's 9.5, 10.
So they're little.
This one's small. It's...
So that's cool.
8.5 or whatever. So I had one set already and I forgot to show it last time.
Because they were in here.
Yes, and they were in here. I'd kind of keep them on the shelf up there.
Because they're pretty, like a little bouquet.
Because I actually had started a pair of scrappy socks and I have a couple of them wound up. Oh,
this See, like this here. Is a good size one, the Doctor
yes.
one.
Yes, no, no, that's trench coat. Yeah. That's trench coat because I have that one too.
Look, they're like little flowers.
Yeah, I have the the set for that one. And so I bought a second set. Because I could see making...
So you don't know what you get.
No, you okay. get whatever. Because if you look, there's like trench coat, there's trench coat, and yeah. that one, that one might be the Doctor.
See, this would be perfect in your little blanket.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah.
I might make a magic knot ball yeah. with these or something, because that would be an awful lot of little, I have to stop and do right. it if I made the ball right. ahead of time. So I wanted to show that. And super fast shipping from her. She's, I ordered on her Etsy shop. Turtle Pearl.
Turtle Pearl.
And I get a drink of water.
Me too. Talk amongst yourselves.
So I have two sets of those now. I can put them in a blanket or yeah. make a cowl that Scattering Petals by Dana Raymond mm-hmm. makes. It's a mini skein mm-hmm. kind of cowl with a cool texture.
That muscle bird hat is meant yes. for a little stripe. Yes. So that'd be cool.
Okay, I got a little bit more to show.
You want to do the fruity things first?
Oh, okay, sure. Okay, Premier Yarn has some new yarn cut that came out. And
these are mine.
It's called Fruits.
She gives me all the good stuff.
They have like some DK weight or whatever, worsted weight cake. Mm-hmm. It's called Fruits. And it's the same colorways, but in a heavier yarn.
I hope that focuses when we do that, because I cannot tell. So, is it focusing?
I don't know.
But this one's called Dragon Fruit, and it really does look like a dragon fruit.
And it's 250 grams. It's 50 grams gain, so order two.
She said that one's for me.
That she can have that one. So, and it's sock yarn.
But I've never seen it. Where did you find them at?
Premiere.
I
their
mean,
website.
Just went on, or you got the email? Or?
Cinnamon Stitches. That's another podcast I like to watch is Cinnamon Stitches. And she, I think she's kind of like an affiliate for Premiere. That's like her all-time favorite yarn. And she was showing the new new stuff. And then this past week was Premiere week for her. So she was like showcasing yarns and did patterns for each kind of yarn. Sure. And but she showed previously the new fruit yarn. And she mm-hmm. showed the sock yarn. So I immediately had to go on Premiere's website and order some. Because this one's called Watermelon.
Which really looks like watermelon.
So I ordered.
No, I can't tell. I think it shows. I think it focuses.
Yeah, so I get two balls of that. I'm keeping the watermelon. I ordered like four and told her to pick, and she only picked one.
I like dragon fruit. It really looks like dragon fruit. That's cool.
And this one, I figured, I really thought you'd pick
the
purple.
I have so much purple.
Yeah, I ordered this because it's purple for you.
I know, but that's cool.
But I'll use it. I like purple,
I
too.
I like black, too.
So that's grape.
Grape.
And that's how it's going to knit up. It kind of reminds me a little bit of the Felici, but not as soft. Because Felici sometimes can be a little bit too soft.
Too soft, yeah.
And then this is blueberry. So that's from Premiere.
I love blueberry.
Did that. And then three more things and I'm done. I'm sure I bought way more and don't remember. And it's on the shelf and I...
Crunkled?
Yes. Kay Jones of the Bakery Bears. Her and her husband have a podcast. That's one of the Patreons on. I love them. You think I'm crazy about Crazy Soft Lady? I love the Bakery Bears. I love them. That's one of the Patreons I do. And Kay was saying that... What's her name? Barrett Wolko?
Oh.
Susan B. Anderson.
Oh, okay.
Susan B. Anderson. She does a lot of the amigurumi or knitted animals.
Right.
She contacted Kay and asked if it was okay if she did a sock set for her crunkled sock pattern.
Oh.
Kay has a crunkled sock pattern. And Kay showed this exact set.
Oh.
And it is...
I've never heard of the crunkled sock pattern, but okay. What's all the noise?
Home fingering weight. This is a set called... Priscilla and Feel. This is exactly what Kay picked. I just thought it was so cool. And this is not superwash wool. This is wool.
Oh, okay.
And apparently it's also very good for socks. It wears very well. And part of the kit was Barrett Woolco.
You got it.
It's like stitch markers. As you can hear, it's stitch markers. So. And I like the crunkled set.
I've never seen
sock, that. Sock. It's... I have the pattern. I should have pulled the pattern out. And
I'll look it up.
I did it. But it's like some yarn. And she calls it her... and I think she still has the sets.
Cool.
Cool. She came out with a new one. I just saw, I got an email from Barrett Woolco that was in my email this morning. She has a new set out for Cowl or something. I can't remember. But she's got a brand new set that she contacted somebody and asked if, because she'll, you know, if somebody has an existing pattern, she'll contact them and say, do you mind if I offer this a set of yarn to go with your pattern? And then in the email, I mean, there's like, I don't know, 6 or 8 different things that she's done this for. You know, and so you know, go check out her stuff. And that's cool. So I bought that kit, and I'm going to eventually start some Clunkled socks.
Cool.
See how woolly wool does for socks.
Woolly wool.
Yeah, because we don't really do, I don't wear socks all the time anyway. I just like making them.
Me too.
Okay, and a recent purchase I made was...
That's your favorite.
With our lovely friend, not friend, I call her a friend, our lovely dyer.
I don't think she's mine.
I don't think she... Maria of Tuscan Knits. I absolutely adore her yarn. And I think this is like one of her first colorways. Where's it at?
There.
Goldberry.
Yeah.
And this is her Fife 100% Superwash Merino. I now have enough where I can make a sweater over the time. And look how well they all kind of go together. They were bought at different times.
Yeah. You still want to alternate if you're going
to. Oh, yeah. That. Yeah. But, you know, it depends on what it is. I may or may not care if I'm going to.
Right.
This is one day going to be a top or a sweater or something. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 skeins of this.
That's pretty.
I also have...
Get it?
5 skeins of her Raindrops on Roses and Whiskers on Kittens. And I think I have a flax light started over there, but it doesn't really have enough to show. So... And actually, if I was wild and crazy, that would be a good combo right there. So, love me some Tuscan Knits.
What about that?
So, that was a purchase. And then, the lovely Molly of Molly Klein Design.
That's your favorite.
Yes.
That's not my
favorite. That's kind of hard to see. I ordered 1, 2, 3, 4.
Really,
and then, I actually ordered 6 skeins. And then, I already had this in her sock yarn. Walk to Remember, that's my absolute favorite colorway of hers. For some reason, this one just speaks to me.
I mean, I like it, but it's just, I think if it was cream, I'd like it more.
I love...
The pink throws me.
And I love the mauve.
Yeah.
I love the mauve and the pink.
But I don't look good in pink.
And those really cool acid pops, like in the other sock yarn.
That I like.
So I have like 2 or 3 quantities of sock yarn.
And that would go together too. The Tuscan and that would go together.
Yeah. Yeah, but I do. I love.
I know the contrast.
I'm really liking that.
That's cool. It's a cool contrast.
I don't know. I may.
That'd be a cool stripe.
I was sitting there thinking that. That would be a really cool. I might rip that
out.
Make a stripe cardigan.
Or you can be really, really wild and make it, you know, your trick to do the.
The helical?
Yeah. And stripe and then steek it.
Ah.
You can do it.
Do not hold your breath. Because what I could do, I've got a flax light started over there, just barely past the collar. And I could, I don't know, maybe like get it to where I split for the sleeves.
Yeah.
And then stripe down in the bottom part of it.
Yeah.
I don't know. We'll see.
Or hold them together and do a...
No, I don't want to do the marled thing. I want, because both yarns are too pretty, you know, so they can shine by themselves. Okay. That's it.
That's it.
We are 1 hour and 22 minutes
Not bad for being a mom.
If you're still here watching, thank you so much for hanging with us. Dog gagging, dropping of crochet hook, talking too loud to speaker. Apologies for all of that. Bag crinkling. Try not to do that. But if this is your first time, this is how we are. If you're a returning viewer, you know that this is what you get.
Yeah.
So I think
let me grab our clicker.
Oh, yeah, we fancy. So
I think that's it. So just leave your comments of, you know, if you finish something.
Yeah.
And you can just say, yo, I tagged you on Instagram. Like, you don't have to redo the whole spiel if you don't want to.
If you're working on something and you're not on Instagram, just kind of, you know, list it below or whatever. Right. And that way. And
we'll pick.
I don't know when you're going to do it, but.
Next week or so. We'll see how the week goes. It's easier on a computer.
Yeah.
Because I use the.
Oh, do it at work.
Comment picker thing. So I do it at work.
Yeah.
I can watch.
Yep, you should do when you get breaks.
But yeah,
I think that's it. Yeah.
So we'll see how it goes if we can keep it more. Once a month so far works, but we we try more. It's just stuff happens.
Yeah, and you got spring days coming. Spring holidays coming. Yeah. So.
Yeah. So, less than a month. So.
And then we got cruising Cajun Country in May.
Okay. So maybe we'll try the week before my holy days. Otherwise, let's wait till after.
Mm-hmm.
So, because somewhere in there, I'm also going to be on the program probably with Carrie talking about the V word you're not allowed to say. So.
Really? Not allowed to say it?
Well, you can get the dinged.
Yeah, the warning and all that. Yeah.
Well, so. We have book club for the real Anthony. F word book.
Gotcha.
Book club, I think, is late.
You knew that
April.
Would be an F word.
I know. He is an F word, that's for sure. I think that's the end of April. So I've still got 8 hours left to listen to it.
Okay.
It's like this big.
Wow.
It's really big.
Wordy little fella, isn't he?
Well, it was Robert F. Kennedy that wrote it.
Oh,
it's about
I like him.
So I do too. He's one of my main crushes.
Junior.
Yes, Junior.
He's a junior.
Well, yeah, I know that.
But you didn't say Junior.
Because the real Robert F. Kennedy is dead. So everyone knows that. He's a junior. Actually, he goes by Bobby Kennedy now, just like his daddy did. So.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, so that book club, I think, is in April. So I have 8 hours left to listen to that.
Yeah, and our cruising thing is mid-May.
Okay. So.
I think we're done.
Appreciate y'all for hanging around. If you have any questions, just leave us comments or send an email.
Yeah.
Or just harass us
we
on
like
Instagram,
comments.
Whatever.
Yeah.
We're needy. It's okay. Yeah. And hopefully you have a lovely day. It's a lovely, beautiful day here. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go home and knit and hopefully knock out that blanket.
We've got, Mark's got ribs on the grill. We're going to have ribs, smashed potatoes, and he found a really good coleslaw recipe.
Oh,
really,
I don't like
really good. So eating good again today.
All right. I'm making salmon and asparagus and rice.
Ooh, that
sounds good
too.
And I got a meal prep because me and Paul got to get real. These pants is getting way too tight. Nope.
I just buy stretchy pants.
I can't buy any more pants. I gotta get myself back for the pants that I own. I can't buy any more pants.
I just buy stretchy pants. All right, y'all.
All right.
Thank you so
Hopefully
much.
Hopefully this works. We'll see how many clicks it takes.
Yeah.
So bye.
See y'all next time.
Nope, didn't work that time. One more click.